Hi, welcome back to Charles Side. In today's tutorial, we'll do the 90 FPS Battlegrounds mobile gameplay test in the iQ7 device by using the config file. Yes, friends, finally, this is a video for all the iQ7 users who are actually waiting for this video for a very long time. And let me try to explain you all the things to know about this config file as well. And I'll try to post in the Telegram group in case if you want to download, you can join my Telegram group. So this is the exact name of my Telegram group. So you can join my Telegram group and you can download the config file. So there are two things first you need to take care. First, let's see whether this config file is actually supporting in the iQ7 device or not. That is what my main motive is. To check whether it's supporting in this phone, we need to use the real-time refresh rate. So let me need to turn on the real-time refresh rate by going into the system and going into developer options. So I'll try to scroll down. Here you can actually find the option which is called the show refresh rate, as you can see. First, let's enable that option. Okay, so if you try to enable that option, if the game, if the Battlegrounds mobile supports the 90 FPS config file, we'll be able to see it will be displaying 120 instead of 60. That is the main reason. Always do like this because before checking. If you cannot find developer options, you need to go to the about phone, click on the software info and try to click on the build number, then you'll be able to get the developer options enabled. So once you've done those, let's go to the display options. So yes, it is a display option. Let's check whether we are using the 120Hz refresh rate or not. That's also confirmed. So we are trying to use the 120Hz refresh rate. That's good. So now everything is set and let me try to exactly. So in case if you have any other config file which is working in your iQ7 device, so make sure to send that config file to this email. Just mention in the subject iQ7 90 FPS config file. So I'll be able to download and test in my phone as well whether it's working or not. So this is my email, friends. For any kind of queries, you can send to this email as well. So first you need to download one file manager, any file manager. I'm not recommending any particular, but in my case I'm trying to use the CX file manager. That is a very easy file manager which is very flexible to use. That is the reason I'm trying to use the CX file manager. So once you download that file, so which posted in the Telegram group, you need to download and extract it. So just click on this folder which you, after extracting, this is a pack file. So this one game patch, you need to copy it. As you can see, try to copy and now go back to the main screen. So here is the main screen and here we do have the option. First you need to go to the Android. As you can see, friends, just go to the Android, next data, and then search for the folder which is com.mobile.pubg.imobile. Let's search pubg.imobile. Keep on scrolling. Yeah, it is a folder, as you can see. And now go to the files and then go to the UE4 game, as you can see, and next go to the Shadow Tracker Extra and again click the Shadow Tracker Extra only, and next go to the saved. And next go to the packs. So is the option which is called packs, and now click paste. So since in this way you'll be able to paste the patch file in this folder, as you can see, friends. So this is the exact method. You can actually pause this video as well in case if you want to remember the process. So once after everything is done, let me need to close everything in the background. Everything is completely closed and let me need to open the BGMI game. So is a Battlegrounds mobile game. Let's see, friends, whether we are able to play it 90 FPS, whether the 90 FPS option is actually displayed in the Battlegrounds mobile game or not. That is what I'm going to check exactly. Let's see whether we can actually get that or not. And this is a Battlegrounds version which is a 1.5 version only. Exactly, I'm trying to show you in the process of demonstration. Let me go to the settings and show you whether we'll be able to get the 90 FPS option or not. And yes, we are getting the 90 FPS, as you can see, friends, in this iQ7 device using the config file. But thing is that even if you use the config file, this refresh rate is not changing to 120, as you can see, absolutely. And I did try to select 90 FPS everywhere. So sometimes some config files, that doesn't work properly. Even though they display the 90 FPS in the settings, they doesn't work properly. So I need to do one more test. I'll try to use the same config file in the MI11X device and Poco X3 Pro and other phones. I'll try to test how their phones are detecting whether they're working or not properly. But in the iQ7 device at this moment, I cannot see any kind of working for the 90 FPS at this point. But the option got enabled, but the option in the settings, we can actually see that, but I cannot see any kind of improvement in terms of the refresh rate. As you can see, it's still at 60 only. You can clearly see, friends. So this is what the problem is. And in case if you have any other working config file, so send me the email file attached. That will be really great to see. So I just want to test those kind of files even in my phone as well, testing whether it will work or not. so it doesn't matter what match I play, still I cannot make it increase to 120 hertz. That's the kind of sad part, friends. So if it increases to 120 hertz, I thought of using the external FPS meter and to test it in the IQ7 device whether it's kind of supporting and it's kind of consistent or not, but that's not the case. So right now at this moment, this is a situation for the IQ7 users, unfortunately. I can definitely understand. So without 4D vibrations and without voice changes and without 90 fps, it's kind of really tough for the gaming people in the IQ7 users. So let's see, let's hope for the best. Maybe very soon they need to update in the IQ7 as soon as possible. But this is a quick review, friends. I'll try to do the couple of minutes gaming review. In case if you want to end the video, you can definitely end that. I just want to do some kind of gaming and just want to end this video. So right now, as you can see, friends, but still I'm not getting any kind of more than 60. It's not increasing at all, so doesn't matter. So even we see the 90 fps, but still it's like our dream to see the IQ7's 90 fps in the settings, but it's my dream to see the refresh rate to increase 120 and even the fps to get actual 90 fps working, not just the config file. So I'll try to use different kind of maybe GFX tool or other things to test. So meanwhile, I'll try to download different config file as well to see whether it's working or not. So meanwhile, make sure to stay tuned, and in case if you have any other config tool, so don't forget to send me the email. That will be really great to test in this phone mainly, especially. That's what I'm going to do for the next couple of days, testing the config files in the IQ7's phone. I need to do the battery draining test as well in the IQ7 device. So after the Battlegrounds Mobile 1.5 version, a lot of users ready to ask me this kind of question about the battery draining test. So which I'll be definitely planning to do as soon as possible. Thank you for watching this video, friends, and I'll see you in the next video. Until then, stay tuned for more updates. Hopefully, I'll try to find the config file which is actually working in the IQ7 device very soon, as soon as possible. And see you in the next video, friends. Until then, bye.